know why I stopped here. Have you ever heard about Hitman's Wife's Bodyguard? The movie, Samuel L. Jackson, Ryan Reynolds, Selma Hayek. You know the movie?
Yeah.
Hollywood filmed some scenes for that one right there on that cliff. Some guy jumped from a 35-meter cliff, 110 feet for you, right?
Yeah.
You see that pole down there? It's the underwater passage which leads to the cave. And after he jumped, he swam inside for that big action scene.
Wow.
Fun fact, now I'm sorry.
I'm going to go.
Zašto si prišao muc?
Ideš ti na sastanak, isto.
Ovo je pravi setup za učiš špil. Ovo je pravi setup za učiš špil.
Sada trajati ljudima tvoji glavu.
Pomogaj čovjek. So what you think, guys? Is it good?
Because that's why you swim under, isn't it? So is that just a life from outside?
Okay, guys. So for the public, the cave was discovered in 1884 by Austrian baron and painter Eugen von Ransone. And a few years later, he brought his first guest here from Vienna. And that's how actually tourism started here. The cave is 24 meters long, or 75 feet, 15 high, 16 deep, or 45 feet. It has three entrances. Two of them are natural, one is artificial. And the artificial one is the one that we came in just now. Back then, they blew it up with the dynamite, that entrance, for commercial purposes, so we can be here today with the boat. And this is the original entrance right there. You see the light coming from the right side?
Yeah.
There's a small hole, but I'll show you that hole from outside because usually we don't go inside that small room. And now this is the third entrance, in my opinion, the most beautiful one, and definitely most important one for the cave. This is where the magic happens, right? It's possible to go outside from here, meter and a half down, 3.5 across. And a few hundred euros for a penalty ticket? Because swimming is not allowed here, not anymore. The cave is protected by UNESCO, that's why. And the second reason is huge amount of visitors. We have 2,000 people every day here, so swimming is not an option anymore, unfortunately. And you know maybe why it's so blue? What makes it so blue?
Sunlight. I think no, there are something coming from
the sunlight coming.
The light? Coming from the outside. Okay, before my colleague come, I open the picture. So this is all fake. And down there on the bottom is the LED lights from Amazon. Here my remote control.
I can change the colors if you want.
Of course it's the light. The light comes under that underwater entrance through the sea, right? And down there on the bottom is specific white sand which acts as a mirror and reflects that light inside. Be careful. You see this?
You from the right side now, you can see something white on the bottom. That is white sand. You from the left side, you can see that white sand bottom is bigger.
And now look up on the ceiling now. Tell me, can you spot the shape of white heart, the symbol, right there? White heart, heart. You see that? You guys? You can see?
Yeah.
Yeah, I made it for my girlfriend. Now she's my wife, so it worked.
How could I make one?
And now from this position, if you want, I can take the pictures for you guys, but we have to be very, very quick. You too, right?
Yeah.
Usually this bay is overflowing with boats, but it is your lucky day today. so you can actually see the bay. This is one of our sightseeing stations. Usually, we give you the option to jump into the water and swim to the beach to see it. A bit more detailed, but we can't go near the beach because it's prohibited. But the reason why you can see it from here and there isn't 100 boats here is because there is a lot of jellyfish here in the last couple of weeks. So people get stung a lot and then they avoid this. Usually we give you around 20 minutes, 30 minutes here to see it. But it is my personal recommendation that we skip swimming here because the next stop is 7 minutes away. That is your prime swimming destination. That is where we can drop you off at the beach. It's too far, you can walk into the water. And you can avoid the stings. So yeah, we're going to give you more time there.
Is there always jellyfish?
No, actually it's like seasonal. There's like a little period where there's so many of them you can't really eye shoot. So we'll show you the... We'll show you the bay from a couple of angles. You take some photos, make people jealous, and then we go.
Sounds good.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hola.